somehow learn the technique or manage to tune yourself with your being and open the Anandamaya Kosha, the bliss space, continuously you will be able to stay in that space. Continuously staying in that space is what I call Nitya Ananda, the eternal bliss. Eternal bliss. That is what I call the state of being. You exist in three levels: being, having and doing. Some people exist only in the level of doing, workaholics. They can't relax. The moment they relax from the work, they feel that they are not needed. Even if they don't get money, they will not be able to relax from that work. Many people I have seen, they take up some social service just because they can't keep quiet. Please understand, if you take up social service or serving others just because you can't keep quiet, you will only damage the society than helping. You will be only creating more misery. Unless you are totally in tune with yourself, how do you think you can help others? You can serve others. Many times I discourage people from serving. Usually, when you take up serving, usually people take up serving others just because they can't keep quiet. The first side effect will be ego. My name should be displayed. I should be given priority. This should be my place. This is the way I'll do. First side effect of doing service just because you can't keep quiet is ego, which is more dangerous. That's a beautiful Zen saying. Even if a master kills somebody, it will do good to that person. Ordinary egoistic person, even if he serves others, it will do only disturbance to others. It is the quality of your being which decides whether you are going to do good or bad to the society, to the humanity. If you take up any service just because you can't keep quiet, just because of your workaholic attitude, be very clear, neither you will be peaceful nor others will be peaceful. Let it be, let all the service be outcome of bliss and joy, then you will never expect any other result. It's a beautiful story. Bodhidharma goes to China. There, he was received by the king of China in the border. The king is very devoted to Buddhism. He has built thousands of monasteries. He has translated all Buddhist scriptures to Chinese language. And he has done all possible things to spread Buddhism. He is standing in the border and receiving the Bodhidharma. After receiving Bodhidharma, he asks Buddha, please tell me, I have done so much of service to Buddhism. What will I get after death? What is the reward for me? Because I have done so much of service. It's a wonderful story. He says, I asked so many Buddhist monks. They told me that I will reach the seventh heaven. But I wanted to listen from you. What will I get after my death? What will be the reward for me? For all this service. Bodhidharma is a very honest man. Very honest man. Straight away he says, doesn't even bother that he is a king of this country. He says, I can be sure of one thing, you will reach only seventh hell. They were totally shaken. The king was totally shaken. He said, what are you talking? I have done so much for Buddhism. How can you say that I will reach seventh hell? Bodhidharma makes a beautiful statement. If you have really done the very service itself is a reward. if you have really done this out of your joy and bliss, out of your, from your being, the very service itself is a reward. You have done from your doing. Just because you can't keep quiet, your whole personality is centered on doing. Our personalities will be centered in three levels. Either it will be centered in being level, or having level, or doing level. Person who is centered in doing level, he is in hell. There's one more beautiful statement Bodhidharma makes. Don't think you will do some sins and then reach hell. You are doing sins because you are in hell. You will never hurt others. You will never be violent with others if you are happy, peaceful within yourself. You will do sinful acts. You will do wrong things because you are in hell. Very doing wrong things shows that we are in hell. Very doing right things shows that we are in heaven. Don't think you will do some sinful acts then go to hell. You are in hell because of that you do sinful acts. Don't think you will do some good things and then reach heaven. No. You do good things because you are in heaven. The very mood with which you do the activities, that is heaven or hell. Heaven or hell is not geographical, it is psychological.